family disputes that degenerated into slanderous name-calling feuds frequently appeared in antebellum Illinois circuit courts. And such cases reflected the intent of American slander law to safeguard an individual's good reputation in the community against petty character assassination. Abraham Lincoln realized the value of reputation and declared in his first printed political speech that every man is said to have his peculiar ambition. I have no other so great as that of being truly esteemed of my fellow men. One unique slander case, Abraham Lincoln argued at the Wick County Circuit Court, Clinton, Illinois, in May of and October 1955 terms involved much more than a defamation of character and suggested that Huck Finn's friend Jim might have recognized his plan to escape to freedom. I reckoned that by following morning, I slipped in just before daylight and swim ashore and take to the woods on the Illinois side. In August of 1851, Jim Dundee, a dark-skinned young man of Portuguese descent, married a European woman, Joseph Spencer's sister. A family quarrel ensued, which became so bitter that in January 1855, Joseph Spencer, a European, claimed throughout the community that his brother-in-law, Black Bill, was a Negro. Since 1819, Illinois state law permitted quasi-slavery and restricted the immigration of free blacks into the state. As other northern states passed personal liberty laws granting additional rights to free blacks, Illinois state tightened its stance against them, and in 1848, Illinois state constitution required the General Assembly to pass such laws as will effectively prohibit free persons of color from immigrating to and settling in this state. Those prohibitions against human rights were passed as the Black Laws and went into force on February 12, 1853, the same date of the future emancipator Lincoln's 44th birthday. William Dungy faced losing not only his reputation, but his marriage, his property, and his right to remain in Illinois. Section 10 of the 1853 Black Law stated that every person who shall have one-fourth Negro blood shall be deemed a mulatto. William Dundee retained Abraham Lincoln to quash the possibility that he might be judged a Negro and therefore suffer the severe penalties under the 1853 Black Laws Act. Abraham Lincoln filed his declaration charging Joseph Spencer with slander on April 17th of 1855 and sought $1,000 in damages. A game of legal chess occurred during the first hearing in May. Joseph Spencer's attorneys Clifton H. Moore and Lawrence Weldon, also Europeans, filed a demur to Abraham Lincoln's declaration, asserting that his charges were insufficient in law. Judge David Davis agreed that two of Abraham Lincoln's three charges were faulty. The case was continued, and Abraham Lincoln was allowed to amend the declaration. At the next term of court, October 1855, the Dundee case was argued before a jury. According to Joseph Spencer's attorney,